Let's talk about spiral tuning today and compare it to what you know on the standard diatonic. At first, I had a fear that if I learned any alternate tunings, then I would make mistakes compared to what I was already familiar with on the standard diatonic. That didn't turn out to be so. So I've experimented with a number of different tunings and really enjoyed all of them. The spiral tuning is how the harmonica should have been invented in the first place. I think more people would have created more music, had more fun, and far less frustration if they'd gone to spiral instead of standard diatonic. But that's the history of our American blues, and so if it's traditional blues you are playing, that's the right instrument to use for it. Everything else, for expression, improvisation, creativity, spiral has a lot of advantages. So I want to compare what you know from the standard diatonic in second position. I'm going to use a C harp, and we draw, and we're in second position G. And then parallel that to the spiral tuning, and you can see how close you are to branching out to this. So here's draw 2, 3, 4 on the standard diatonic in second position G. And if I go one more hole, you get the sound of the dominant seventh, which is core to historical blues. If you want to go to what the country tuning is like, here's the sound of the spiral doing 2, 3, 4, and 5 raise. And so when you get to doing 3 chords in a song, on the standard diatonic, you're stuck with that flat fifth hole. There's the beautiful 5 major chord built in. So that's essentially the power of the country tuning. If you want to play what you get with a melody maker, we have the second tone built in as the blow 3 hole rather than bending 3 hole down. And it sounds wonderful as a blues tool. As far as hitting the note clean, spiral. And you can still bend the draw 3 to half bend as you do on standard diatonic. Let me show you some chords that are available on the spiral. Let's go draw 2, 3, 4. And that's your G major chord, just as you would use in second position on a C harp, G major chord. So I've used that cascade approach so you can hear the root, third, and fifth come in from each chord. And what we have there is 6 chords, 3 majors, 3 minors, and we have the bulk of our popular songs available to us. Lots of exceptions, of course, but you can do a lot. And you're not always playing full chords like that in a parallel movement, as we do there, but that just gives you an idea of the chords. If you're accompanying, spiral can be real handy, whereas on diatonic you'll go to at least 2 harps to get that third chord of the blues changes. And you've got the 3 major chord groups there. If you like what you've heard about spiral, go to my website, dukeofwail.com, W-A-I-L. Go to the contact page. Mention that you saw spiral video number 1 and you'd like some documentation on what we've talked about. In the next episode, it's going to be introducing major scale and the relative minor on the spiral.